好，我是千鸟，今天要为大家带来的是《全境封锁资料片》。今天大家继续看看接下来的电话录音。
Are you recording this? No, no, that's fine. One more time, you're gonna let me go, right? That was the deal. Anyway, my name is Sharona Diaz, and I was a nurse practitioner at Bellevue, the hospital. Worked there 16 years, so I've seen all kinds of bad stuff, but nothing like this. Okay, I'm sorry, the first cases we got? Early December, the night of the 5th. They started coming in, just a couple at first. The symptoms they presented looked like flu, and that's what we thought it all was. I mean...We knew it was going to be a bad season, and that's what we thought this was. So we gave them fluids and sent them home like you do. I mean, how are we supposed to know? But the thing is, the patients kept on coming. I mean, you work ER, you're always ready for a bad night. But this was every day, and it never stopped. More people coming in, same symptoms.You'd see parents shivering next to their kids, with the kids trying to keep it together, and your heart, it just broke for them. 3-4 days of this, we're pretty sure it's not flu. DCD was calling every couple of hours for updates, and they asked all these questions that made it pretty clear they didn't think it was flu either. What the disease control department finally told us was scary. This thing...Nobody was saying smallpox yet. Was virulent at 2 parts per million. Direct contact airborne contagion too. It was scary. Then the governor declared it an emergency and they locked the city down and we realized what kind of hell we were going to be in for. The National Guard moved in. But what were they going to do? They weren't doctors. The 8th was when somebody finally said smallpox.Word came down that we were supposed to inoculate healthy patients with smallpox vaccine, even though our supplies were old and nobody knew if it would even work. The thing was, it didn't. People kept getting sick and coming in, and we just didn't have the room. We did what we could to make people comfortable, but we just couldn't stop it. We couldn't even slow it down.
Eh?
That's when it all turned into alphabet soup. First Sarah rolled into town, thinking they got this under control. Catastrophic Emergency Response Agency. More like, can't even run anything. They started setting up these mass treatment facilities in Midtown, which took a load off us, but didn't do much else. On the 11th, people started dying. By the 13th, the morgues were full.And on the 14th, we had to start turning people away. It was hell, you know? But we couldn't do anything for them. We were out of beds, we were out of medicine, the staff were starting to come down with it. It was a nightmare. By the 17th, they shut us down. Too much risk of infection, they said. More like they wanted to concentrate all the patients in those Sarah Field hospitals.Maybe keep it away from the rest of the city. What happened next? You know what happened next. The Joint Task Force tried to hold things together, but really, what were they gonna do? Cops and firefighters and weekend warriors? The city was falling apart. Too many people were sick, too many jobs weren't getting done. And then, they lost control of those Sarah facilities and had to wall them off.It was just too much. Me? I got out before they shut the doors to the dark zone. And now all I want is to go home. You're gonna let me go, right? You said you were gonna let me go.
感觉就不会，最后没有办法放他走，怕感染。
Understood. Yes, ma'am. Yeah, I was in the dark zone when we pulled out. Yeah, I'm okay to talk about it. My name? Specialist Robert Armitage Jr. Army National Guard, New York. 42nd Infantry Division. Yes, ma'am, it's a mouthful. Electronics engineer, wife and two kids in Utica. Mobilized mid-December after the governor declared a state of emergency. We knew there was an outbreak. We didn't know of what. No, ma'am. My experience, they don't tell you those things unless they're relevant. And it wasn't. Not yet. Well, you join up, you pretty much give them leave to do whatever they want to you.
最后还是没有.
When did I get to Manhattan? Early days, right after the outbreak. They mobilized us on the 7th, had us in transports to the city on the 8th. Quarantine was already coming down. It was weird as hell to be traffic going into Manhattan and not see anything coming out. People hadn't started dying yet, but already things were pretty shaky. Half the city was sick, and the other half didn't go to work because they were afraid of getting sick. Our initial orders were to liaise with Sarah and provide support. Build aid stations and help them set up those field hospitals. City policing we left to the civil authorities. So they could see we were getting stretched pretty thin. But we built structures. We safeguarded supply drops. We handed out blankets and water bottles. And we held the line on the quarantine. Nobody was getting off the island. Not if we could help it. Had to shoot a few people who tried. I'm not proud of that. Then people started dying. For real dying. Not just old folks and kids. People were dropping dead in the streets. People dying in their apartments and nobody would find it for days. The hospitals? They were turning people away because they had nothing left. But that was okay. Because Sarah had those mass treatment centers and they were gonna be it. By that point, the cat was out of the bag on the smallpox thing. But we still had hope, you know? Sarah was gonna beat this thing, and then we were all gonna go home. Meanwhile, the city was falling to shit around us. The ATF? They were trying, doing their best during all this. Firemen, cops, crossing guards, you name it. All of them trying to keep things running when the water stops flowing and the lights start going out. And all you got is a badge and a promise that things are gonna get better? People start getting crazy in the streets, stealing food, taking it from their neighbors. What are you gonna do? After a while, they linked us up with them and called us all JTF. But it still wasn't enough. Early days, there was talk of hooking up with that PMC someone paid to guard their offices in Wall Street. Last Man Battalion, they were called. Complete bunch of shitheads. If they played ball, maybe things wouldn't have gotten so bad. But their CO, this Bliss asshole, he decides they're not working with nobody. So suddenly we got a war going with those guys while the disease is out of control. Not enough we got a superbug trying to kill us. Goddamn Merc's gotta try it too.
原来幸存者军队是佣兵哦。
But that's all besides the point. Because the real problem was, those treatment centers, they failed. Everybody died. The patients, the doctors, the nurses. The poor sons of bitches dumping bodies into the mass graves they had to dig in Central Park. Everyone. People dying on the inside, people shooting at us on the outside. When they finally told us to pull out, it was a blessing. Now, all that's behind barbed wire. Yeah. That's where your dark zone came from. And the things I've seen, I don't care how much you're offering, I'm never going back in.
没关系，安全我去，给我金装。
God damn it! I was there. I was right there. I could have saved those people. I could have saved the whole fucking situation. Here's what I don't get. How do you recruit the best of the best and not allow them to do their fucking job? Son of a bitch! Thing is, we pull out now, we can't ever go back. The whole area just becomes one big dark zone. Totally lawless. Jesus, we're letting them win. Stop it. Stop being a pussy. Get a fucking grip. Think, goddammit. Idiots. Motherfucking idiots. How dare they? How dare they?
这么急男是谁啊？
Okay. First of all, I owe myself an apology. Emotional outbursts are unacceptable, certainly unprofessional, no matter how provoked. So, I apologize. I forgive myself. I move forward. Good. Now, the question of the moment, this betrayal, this changes things. Things have changed. This is clear. We have been lied to. We are sent to do a job. Things get tough. Suddenly, we're not allowed to do it. Rules are broken. Values discarded. A city abandoned. This is the truth. This is reality. The man behind the curtain. I have to tell the others. Okay, progress report. I've spoken to several other agents about the division's betrayal. This wasn't easy given our cell structure. I only knew the agents in my cell. One was supportive, two were not. Every war has casualties, as I've been reminded. But the one led to others. I'm encouraged. Obviously not everyone will be persuadable, but a 1 in 3 success rate is more than expected. I also received an unexpected connection to Colonel Charles Bliss of the Last Man Battalion. I'm told his might be a friendly ear. I look forward to bending it. Progress report. Colonel Bliss proved receptive. A man of rare wisdom and insight. Not to mention a fine taste in single malts. New challenge. With most of the initial wave of agents either dead or playing dead, the division has apparently activated a second wave. Smaller than the first, it seems. Poor planning. For want of a nail, the war was... I'm sure they're good people. Unfortunately, they can't be allowed to succeed, so we'll have to cut some assignments short. Nobody said saving the world was going to be easy.
吓我是坏蛋欸。
Progress report. It looks like the Last Man Battalion's the best bet, at least in the short term. I've set up the line of communication with Lieutenant Colonel Charles Bliss, and it's proving mutually beneficial. There's a certain overlap of viewpoints there, and some shared ambition. He's a man who has a vision for this godforsaken rock, one that I can work with. We've already collaborated on one operation in Brooklyn, but taking down a helicopter is just a first step. Let's see how far this can go. I've had an idea, and it's a good one. Let's think about the virus. What do we know? That it's similar to smallpox. Not smallpox, but similar. Which means it's a designated variation. Smallpox is the base on which a designer made alterations. Now, live smallpox exists in only two places, DCD and Russia. The base virus had to come from one of them. DCD? I would have heard if their security had been breached. So, Russia. Now let's think about the designer. Are there virologists with connections to both New York and Russia? In fact, there are two. One's Russian, one's American. A little research tells me both were in New York on Black Friday. Thank you, Shade Tech. Let me rethink things a little. Did some more digging into our two virologists, specifically their work. That's where things got interesting. Now, if I'm reading Chernenko's abstract right, there was no need to steal the smallpox, not when it had already been decoded and digitalized and set up to be tucked into an email like any other attachment. And that digital genome was just sitting there, waiting for someone with the right know-how and the right equipment and the right imagination to make it live. This version of New York is just a start. The possibilities are endless. Is there a limit to what can be done? Let's find out.
听起来还蛮恐怖的，左边不小心跳出来，再来看一个好了。
Lieutenant Colonel Bliss, this is Arthur Tran from Polliner Newen Creative Associates. First, let me say what a pleasure it is to be working for a company like yours and with someone like you, so devoted to keeping our great country safe.I've sent you the storyboards for the proposal for your firm, which we're calling Island Thunder. It starts with a flyover by a wing of attack helicopters, all firing full blast. Behind them, there's a massive explosion, followed by a pan down to where we see one soldier in your company's uniform taking out a dozen enemies with a massive machine gun. Tasteful heavy metal, and a voiceover that emphasizes the sorts of awesome adventures your men have been on a day-to-day basis. Tell me what you think.
这是在干嘛
Mr. Tran, this is Charles Bliss calling. I just wanted to let you know that I got your message and I looked at your storyboard, and that your ad is the biggest piece of crap I've ever seen. And that includes the time I got trapped marching behind 16 elephants in a parade. You show no understanding of what my company is, what my people do, or what sort of high-character individuals we're looking to recruit. So...You have 1 week to do better, or I'll fire you, and we'll do better. Do I make myself understood? Bliss out.
Lieutenant Colonel Bliss, sir, first let me apologize for the previous effort we sent you. That was the work of a junior associate who has, of course, since been let go. We've assigned all of our senior staff to your project, and I think you'll be very pleased with the revisions. It's a very simple concept.Just you, talking about your service and the idea of loyalty and duty. And I think we can bring it in at well under your budget, so, call me back and let me know.
应该是在拍他们那个佣兵的广告吧。好，那今天资料就到这边哦。喜欢的话可以帮忙按喜欢，分享出去，订阅我们的频道，获得最新影片的资讯。谢谢大家收看，拜拜。